Main thing I love about science, it's life and its endless possibilities.
I'm really passionate about both art and science.
I've been in love with science and more specifically biology. I'm not necessarily too much of a chemistry fan, but biology is definitely a passion of mine.
It's exciting to see almost 1,200 people in a ballroom and to see all of these oral and poster sessions, over 700, you know, oral and poster sessions, largely undergraduates talking about their research.
I'm really interested in research, especially with health disparities and trying to close the health disparities gaps, specifically in communities like the Somali community back home in Minneapolis.
My project is an ethnobotanical project done at the Missouri Botanical Garden under the direction of Rander Busman.
This is my second time here, and I am studying carbon sequestration at Pea Ridge National Military Park in Arkansas, Northwest Arkansas. And this has been a wonderful opportunity, and I really appreciate the opportunity that the American Association for the Advancement of Science has given us to come and present our research.
A lot of them, they don't necessarily know a lot of scientists of color. And so to come here and see that their judges are of many stripes, to see that they are able to interact at tables, you know, first kind of like with their own group, but then after that branching out and being willing and able to interact with people from other institutions, they're able to kind of get a sense that, well, I'm not in this by myself. But it's a difficult barrier to try to get over when you may be coming from a community where you're not seeing faculty, you're not seeing scientists, you're not seeing engineers who look like you.
So what are you actually hoping to do after you graduate?
Well, I'd like to get into industry, at least for some time, get some experience under my belt, and then maybe go back to graduate school after that so I can get, like, a doctorate and all that.
So you've been looking for, like, internships?
I have.
Yes. I have. Same.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Yeah, so this, what Yolanda was telling you about with this particular program, this is where you should definitely check it out because it's a website where different faculty members and different can upload profiles of positions that you can apply for. And they're everything from like summer research experiences to graduate fellowships to even after your PhD.
I think that the students, the underrepresented group students, have many of the same issues as other students. It's just that in so many cases they can't fake it. They think that because of their background that they maybe aren't as welcomed into the community of scientists.
And it's been a struggle because I, you know, coming from a family with, you know, no college background, you can't really explain to them the stresses of academia.
I have dysgraphia and ADD. Dysgraphia is actually a writing disability.
I've faced age discrimination on different jobs. Racial discrimination too.
So I went to community college and I didn't have a lot of exposure to science and I didn't know which areas would be available as future careers.
Your personal narrative is really important and that you have to understand that anything that happens to you, whether it feels like it's good or it's bad, it is basically going to help to shape who you are and who you can become.
For me, the passion is not being, I guess, the person that they see in the news. It's about just helping others. And I like teaching. And, you know, teaching doesn't get a lot of attention compared to, like, all these scientific breakthroughs and medical areas as well.
Being here at this conference, even presenting the research that I've done, is very hard for me because I'm not a public speaker at all.
They are full of nerves right now because for some of them they're presenting for the first time. And what we have tried to do within this conference is to provide a safe space for that kind of first-time presentation, providing guidance, providing feedback,
So my main research was to develop a stable GFP tag guinea pig cytomegalovirus, and we're mainly studying congenital CMV infection. And the main reason why we're doing this is that currently there is no vaccine or preventative measure to protect babies while they're in utero from the CMV infection.
I don't really care who solves the problems and associated with chemistry and cancer. But it would be criminal, in my opinion, not to have students from diverse backgrounds there at the table trying to solve some of these problems.
I've had an experience working with engineers at NASA during an internship last summer, and I was able to work alongside them in the lab, working with test hardware, a detector actually, and I was able to shadow him as he showed me the different processes such as 3D modeling.
I haven't been to a single meeting where I've seen as many students condensed in one area, and I think that's the value of this program. I just hope between AAAS and National Science Foundation that we can keep this going. It's a whole lot more valuable than anything, than any amount of money. And I realize it has to be pretty expensive bringing all these students up here. But I think that's a real value.